I may just be an old stone head, a corbel up here in the roof of Westminster Abbey, but I know a thing or two about beautiful treasures, and this one here is a real beauty. It's a chalice, a very special cup used for Holy Communion. And this chalice is particularly special to the Abbey as it features a certain king. Look closely, and you'll see a golden figure inside the cup's stem. That is Edward the Confessor, the man who built Westminster Abbey almost 1,000 years ago, and, perhaps more importantly, a saint. How did Edward become a saint? I've heard he was a very generous and Christian king, but I've also heard a story that people often talk about when they think of him. We have to go back to when Edward was king, though by now he was old and frail. He was on his way to dedicate a new church to St. John the Evangelist. As he rode toward the church, he was stopped by a beggar with white hair and a long grey beard. Wanting to help, the king checked his purse but found it empty. He turned to his knights, but none of them had any money. Then he noticed he was wearing a beautiful sapphire ring. He quickly took the ring from his finger and gave it to the beggar. Now my story takes a strange and unusual turn, for a short while later, far, far away in the Holy Land, two English pilgrims found themselves lost in the wilderness. Night was falling, and as they huddled together for safety, they spotted a figure approaching in the darkness. Perhaps this was some fearsome bandit come to rob them. But as he came closer, the pilgrims could see this was no bandit but an old man with white hair and a long grey beard. "Friends," he said, "you are lost. Where do you come from? Where are you going? Tell me of your faith and your king." The pilgrims, much relieved that they were not about to be robbed, shared their story with the old man. They were Christians, travelling to the places where Jesus lived and died before making their journey home to England, ruled over by King Edward. Having listened to their story, the old man led them from the wilderness to a town. He bought them food and drink and paid for a room where they could sleep. The pilgrims asked how they might ever repay the old man's generosity. "Here," said the old man as he presented them with a beautiful ring adorned with a precious sapphire. "On your return home, take this to your king. Tell him this is the same ring he gave me on his way to my church, and that I, St. John the Evangelist, we'll see him in 6 months' time in paradise." And so the story goes that the pilgrims returned to England, and when they came to Edward's court, they returned the ring and passed on St. John's message. On hearing he was soon to die, Edward gave his money to those in need and spent his time in prayer. I hope you like my story. I always think of it whenever I see this chalice and the little figure of Edward there in the middle. It reminds me that even if we have no money to give to the poor, there is always something we can do to help those less fortunate than ourselves.